Talk of a non-contested referendum-dominated speeches at the launch of the BBI report on Monday. But emerging realities may reduce that to just, well, talk. A youth lobby group from Western Kenya seemed to set the scene for a contested referendum today, urging President Uhuru Kenyatta and ODM leader Raila Odinga to ignore those calling for a review of the recently launched BBI report, saying they squandered the opportunities granted to them to give their views. The group wants the referendum held next year in January, as Chemutai Goin reports.
Amid calls for a further review of the final BBI report before it is put through a referendum, Deputy President William Ruto, having joined leaders who poked holes into some of the proposed amendments, a section of leaders from Western Kenya are accusing the Deputy President of failing to present his views in time.
We will not entertain people who want to reopen a discussion that they refused to participate in when the process was going on.
The lobby group wants the implementation process hastened, saying by January they expect to have swayed the required 24 county assemblies to support their cause.
We want to spearhead the collection of signatures starting this weekend in support of the bill. And by the end of November, we should be done with that. We take it to the assemblies, and by January, we should have a date for the bill to be presented before the Houses of Parliament and a referendum in the first quarter.
It is not that it's such a mischievous document. People are just looking for trouble.
And calls by some leaders for a non-contested referendum may well be flying into some heavy weather.
We'll have people who will be there to oppose, because some people are not opposing because the document is bad. They are opposing it for political expedience.
Correct.
Trying to weigh themselves against their opponents before 2022 election.
If we have other motives, then a contentious referendum will help those who have other motives to achieve that motive. And the motive is what I would be saying would be to divide Kenyans and use this document as a mobilization tool to cobble together a 2022 coalition.
Kikuyu Member of Parliament Kimani Ichung'wah, an ally of the Deputy President, says a non-contested referendum would cement the unity call being advanced by the President, calling on him to allow another round of review to enhance inclusivity.
The fact that the document is being pushed towards a certain direction tells you that there are more political motives than anything else. If President Uhuru Kenyatta has a legacy to secure in this less than 2 years, we cannot be wasting it in campaigns for or against a constitution that we can sit and agree on.
Constitutional Professor Ben Sihanya, a member of the BBI steering committee, downplays claims that there is insufficient time to carry out a referendum owing to the upcoming general election.
Some of the proposed amendments to the constitution are so fundamental in restructuring Kenya that it's best that they are conducted before the next elections, so that the next elections are a way of implementing those issues.
He also backs the reconstitution of the poll body IEBC, acknowledging that confidence in the Electoral Commission was key in enhancing peaceful handover.
The three commissioners know it, and Kenyans know that there's a trust deficit, that they cannot be trusted with any electoral or referendum process.
Deputy President William Ruto on Monday expressed his reservations about some of the BBI proposals, saying they needed further review to reflect the views of all Kenyans. Chemutai Goin, Citizen TV, Nairobi.